My name's Joshua Luke, and this is the Sea Lion Challenge filmed on the 13th of the 6th, 2021.
Hi, Josh, how you going?
Good, I'm Karu.
Nice to meet you. We've met before. We're going to be doing a workout today. I've been in contact with a physiotherapist that you were referred to, and she's given me some exercises to give you to help improve your shoulder stability. Especially around the scapular area. I'll demonstrate a few of these exercises, do them in the warm-up, and then we'll progress on to the workout. I thought it'd be pretty light work today. We don't overdo it, and we'll progress as time goes on. All right. So, first exercise is, we're gonna do a warm-up on the assault bike first. Just demonstrate again, so what we're going to do is you just rest the ball here, just in front of you, and we want to just do some circles, slightly slower, up and down, just do that warm up the shoulders. Try and keep that scapula nice and stable, okay? And we'll do it on the other side, same deal. You're not trying to push it as hard as you can, you're just trying to keep the stability in the back here. Circles up and down, putting through its movements. Then we've got, after that, we've got some prone flies. We can go unweighted or weighted. These are only a 0.5 kilogram weight plate, so we won't go any higher than that. We just sit here like this, down, and we come up. Nice and controlled. A few reps there. Once we've done that, come down, rest our head on here so it's a little bit higher. We have an arm here. Don't want your elbows to be higher than your hands, so you want them to be nice and even. We come up, and then we lift down and back. Okay, so that's our warm up. We'll get into that, and then once we're nice and warm, I'll demonstrate what we'll be doing in the workout. So if you just want to jump on the echo bike there for 2 minutes, just take it easy. We just want to get the blood flowing. You can adjust it.
Yeah.
You pull it, pull it. go. Just circles. Keeping this nice and stable. Change the movements. The elbow loop, arm a little bit straight up. Okay, change arms. Not as sudden, more slow controlled movements. It's good. 10 seconds. Come over on here. Just lay down. You want the top of your chest to be on the edge here. Okay. Now we're going to do 20 reps. Nice slide control. Can you get up with that? Keep counting. That's 6, 7. Yep. So
20?
Yeah, just do 20. Oh, sorry, we weren't supposed to do that with resistance. So just keep going. We'll do all the exercises. Bring your arms a little bit more this way. So you're going straight out, just come a little bit more up. Yeah, that's it. What do you have? 12 reps of this. Right there, out, up. So keep going a bit straighter in front of you.
This is very hard to watch you.
It's like this.
Didn't watch the demonstration, obviously. Obviously not.
I obviously did. Is that not what I just did?
You're going out with this one too much, you need to stay in.
Further in front of you, on that waist line, yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's good, keep going then. Halfway. Yeah.
And then we'll just go over here and warm up the legs. So I just do some leg swings. And just stand on the other side here. Yep, okay. 10 each legs. And then I'll start that straight for the workout. So, the workout today, we'll do some more stuff for scapular stability.
Okay.
So, let's get this set up. So, we just want to sit on this bench for me. Just want to set this up properly. So we're coming to the green belly button. Lower. So sorry, well, I'll demonstrate that. We'll leave it there. Just, so we've got dumbbell thrusters. Okay. Let's get the rep range, but this is only 2.5 kilo, nice and light. So all we're doing, we hold in the front rack position, keep your shoulder nice and stable. Down, press. Down, press, and then we'll go on the other side, we'll swap it up. Down, press. Okay? And then we'll have banded external rotations on the shoulder, okay? So we put the band around our wrist like this. Just imagine putting your armpits in your pockets, come down like that, and we just open like that. Slow, control. Until you can feel the tension. It's not about how I just move it further. You just move it to your resistance. If you can only go up that, it doesn't matter. You're still creating the same movement. Okay? Then we've got some rows. We're saying here we can go single arm or we can go double arm. So we can sit. Same deal, protract. Press the scapula, so pull back and into your pockets, down in your pockets, and just pull and pull. We can always increase the resistance, we can move the bench back further, or we can go two hands, open up a little bit like this, or you can hold it like that. So, we just, same deal, contract, press, and pull, okay? Just feel it in the middle of your back, in your lats. Great, great exercise. Alright, and then after that, finish it off to get our core firing a little bit. We're just going to do some cat, camel, bird dogs. Alright, so if you can't do the cat, camel, bird dog, we can just regress it to a bird dog. But this is your cat, camel, okay? That's it there. And then your bird dog, clenched fist. So all we're doing is when we come out to here, we just sink and push. Sink, push. Do a couple of them each side. All right. Huh? What? Great. So we'll start with the single arm dumbbell thrusters. We also have some RDLs in there. Okay. We'll go single leg RDLs. No way, not weightless. Right, so it's just get your balance, come back. Once you feel the tension in the hamstring, back up. Okay. I'll give you the rep ranges as we go. The same deal. Alright. So we'll start with the dumbbell thrusters. We've got 8 reps, We'll break that into four each side, okay? Yep. Get your squat stance, feet a little bit apart, yep. Toes out a little bit, and that's it. Ready?
Yep.
You can go. Nice. Four each side. Yep. Yep. Change arms. Yep. It's good. Nice. Okay. We'll go to the RDLs. I believe we've got six each leg. Or ten, actually, we've got ten, so break that into five, so five reps each leg. You can go one at a time, or you can get all five done on one side. That's it. Remember, if you feel a little bit unstable with your foot, remember to jam that big toe into the ground. Yep, that's good. Legs are nice and straight at the back, looks good. External rotations, because this is generally an easier exercise, we'll do quite a high number of reps. Okay, so like I said, down, and just open. Okay, open. If this is too hard, it won't be, but if it is, we can get rid of this and do the same thing. Okay, so elbows into the side. Okay, get the elbows there. Yeah. Alright, and then it's armpits in your pockets, down. Yep, and open. Press your chin. Keep your elbows. Your elbows can't come off your body. It's all here. Okay?
That's it.
Yeah, that's fine. Doesn't matter.
How many?
25. Feel it in here?
Yes.
Keep going. It's good. Yeah, that's fine. You're only creating resistance. It doesn't need to move.
You can put it with something stiff, even if you just create the resistance, you can't move, but it just engages your muscles. Yeah.
Alright, then we've got some resistance band rows. Alright. We'll go double arm. Actually, no, we'll go single arm. We need to do unilateral work. Physio requested it. So, yep. So, you might need to come back a little bit. We'll see how you go. So, remember to retract and depress the scapula. Yep. And pull. Into the, yep. How's that feel? Yep.
10.
Yep. Don't worry about twisting your fist. Don't twist your fist when you come back. Just keep it.
5 on
each side, 10 on each side. but it's good for you. So what it actually is doing is when you sink into the cat, is you pulling the shoulder blade back and then you're pushing it forward. So you're using muscles that you don't normally use very often.
It's okay, so come down here. Let's go, I'll do it with you. Back, arm forward, clench the fist,
yep,
and sink into the cat. So we're not bending our arm at all,
yep,
just sink back. Okay, then up, up, down, up, four.
Good. I believe that's all. Okay.